Why, I've always loved you. I feel the same way, Applejack. Oh, Sugar Cube. Mwah, 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 mwah.
Oh, hey! Hi, I'm that funky guy, and I'm totally not playing with My Little Ponies. No, not at all. Bubsy! Remember Bubsy?
No, you don't. Well...
let me give you a refresher course on that, okay?
Bubsy was a short-lived series of video games that was grabbing a bit of popularity via the furry mascot platforming game genre that was popular during the 90s, mostly because of a certain blue hedgehog. Bubsy was one of the more popular wannabe games in this style during the time, and it wasn't very good. Despite this, the game still managed to be popular enough to get 3 sequels. It also had enough popularity to get a pilot for a cartoon series that aired alongside the Battletoads cartoon pilot on Thanksgiving of 1993. Doesn't that sound like a match made in heaven?
So grab your favorite sugary cereal and your favorite flavored vodka, because today we're going to watch the Bubsy cartoon pilot.
We begin the show with an intro that has Bubsy making out with a clock and then going to brush his teeth with what appears to be a sander.
What could possibly go wrong?
Oh, and get used to that line because it's his catchphrase and they really try to drive it home to you. I mean, he says it a lot in the game.
What could possibly go wrong?
But they go way overboard with it in the show. I might even say they go over 9,000? Joke is old! And I should probably take this moment to say that Bubsy is being played by Rob Paulsen, a voice actor way too talented for this role. You might know him as Raphael from the 80s Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle cartoon, or Yakko Warner in Animaniacs, or Pinky in Pinky in the Brain. And with a talent like Paulsen on his side, how could Bubsy go wrong? Right? Right? What the hell was that? A rain dance for retards?
Come on! Bubsy will be right back! What could possibly go wrong?
More like what could possibly go right.
They even titled the episode What Could Possibly Go Wrong. We're only a minute into this show, people, and they've already mentioned his catchphrase 3 times. I told you they'd be cranking it up to 9,000. I said stop it! We start the episode by meeting Bubsy's sidekick of sorts, an armadillo named Arnold. He seems to have an extensive and obsessive fear of trucks.
As a resident of Texas, I gotta say his fears are pretty valid. Not funny, but definitely valid.
Bubsy! Oh, worse than a truck!
Yes.
Oh, come on, you know I'm your hero.
No.
Oh, please, do we have to go through this every single morning?
No, don't want to be your sidekick.
Yeah, I know. You don't feel worthy. Hey, that happens when people are around me.
I don't know what's worse here. Bubsy's insane level of denial, or the abusive relationship he has with Arnie. Abusive relationship with Arnie. Yeah, maybe it's like Roseanne and Tom Arnold. Dated humor. Ha ha ha.
And while I'm at it, Arnold is voiced by Pat Fraley, probably best known as Krang from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Are you out of your skull?
Anyways, the doorbell rings, Bubsy mentions his twin niece and nephew are visiting him for their birthday. Arnold panics and Bubsy throws him under the couch. And the twins plow their way through the door and... Oh my god! Those are the ugliest fucking children I've ever seen! And why is the little girl wearing makeup? Isn't she kind of young for that? I just don't know what to say. These really are the ugliest character designs I've fucking ever seen. I hope with all the power of Grayskull that whoever is responsible for these designs got fired!
You're fired!
Whoa! You kill him, Vince!
The kids start tormenting poor Arnold. Bubsy, clearly not giving a shit, turns on the TV and the news reports.
Last year, over 10,000 armadillos were run over by trucks in the state of Texas alone. For many of the poor little fellows, this is the last sound they will ever hear.
Either they're watching the Discovery Channel or this is a really slow news day. Yeah.
This puts Arnold into a panic and he rolls up into a ball. And the twins use the poor armadillo as a basketball. This is probably as good of a time as any for me to point out that the twins are voiced by Tress MacNeille and BJ Ward. Tress MacNeille is probably best known as Babs Bunny from Tiny Toons and Dot from Animaniacs. While BJ Ward is best known as Scarlet from G.I. Joe. And both of them are way too talented to be in this horrible show.
Next, we'll be interviewing Virgil Reality.
Get it?
That's so funny, I forgot to laugh.
So the news show informs us that Virgil Reality has created a new helmet that can turn imagination into reality.
This adventure, if used responsibly, could someday stop war and famine
and make Miru a real person.
And eventually save the entire planet.
So far, it's mostly blown up on Virgil's head.
Hi, Pat Fraley and Tress MacNeille. I sure hope you got paid extra for doubling up in this terrible show.
Oh, boy! Bowling for Dillos!
I can't tell if Arnie's in pain or orgasming.
All I need now is someone extremely brave to test the helmet.
You said you needed someone totally nuts.
Hey, that's me. I'm totally nuts.
Yeah, among other things.
Well, Bubsy decides he'll be the one to test the helmet, and when the twins ask why he wants to, this happens.
Because I am brave. Because I crave adventure. Because I need to go where no bobcat has ever gone before. And because I'm a hero for crying out loud, if that's a crime, then book me.
And before you ask, no, I did not add those clips to the review. The show does that itself. For some reason, the show feels the need to interject random stock footage clips into it. And I guess it's okay. Those stock footage clips are way more entertaining than the actual show is.
Yay, Bubsy, yay!
Die, Bubsy, die!
Hey, what could possibly go wrong?
Yeah, I bet that's what Rob Paulsen said when he read the script.
But Bubsy isn't the only one to hear about this helmet as we get introduced to the villains of the show.
Who I'll point out are not in the game.
The villains include the boss, a fat rich cat named Ali Cassandra, a chef buzzard named Boswell Buzzard, and a shrew named Sid. And in order, they're voiced by BJ Ward, again, Neil Ross, who you might know as Shipwreck from G.I. Joe, and
Jim Cummings! Why are you in this? Why? Why are you in this? You're a big star. A big fucking voice acting star. You should not be in this trash. I mean, you do a whole bunch of shit for Disney and Warner. You're the voice of Winnie the Pooh and Tigger 2. I mean, you're Darkwing Duck. You're the current voice for the Tasmanian Devil. Why are you in this? Why? Why?
I really care what took you so long.
It was a rhetorical question!
I don't care what they're doing, and there's nothing rhetorical about it.
Ali explains the use of the helmet, you know, just in case the audience fell asleep earlier, and how she wants them to steal it for her. Then she looks into a mirror and imagines herself anorexic?
Oh god, I think she looked better fat. And I'm not saying she looks attractive or anything, I'm just saying it looks better than having her look like a cat version of Yzma from The Emperor's New Groove.
So Bubsy goes to what looks like the Modern Art Museum to meet up with Virgil Reality, about the helmet.
Oh yeah, good! Virgil's expecting you, Bucky!
That's Bubsy.
Okay, Booby!
That's not a booby!
Those are boobies!
Yeah, I know. You ladies are gonna hate me for that one.
Welcome, I am Virgil Reality, and you must be Bootsy.
It's Funky.
Bubsy.
Oh yeah.
And it's not funny.
So Bubsy grabs a helmet and says he wants to fly.
What could possibly go wrong?
Buh!
And faster than you can say, what the fuck, the cast is sent falling from a great height. I don't know if the writers are aware of this, but this isn't flying, it's falling.
That wasn't flying, that was falling with style.
Virgil tries to take the helmet and it lands on Arnold.
The truck!
Who has a truck-related orgasm?
Do something, Bubsy!
Bubsy!
Whatever!
Also not funny.
Bubsy grabs the helmet back and wishes everyone back to the lab, except Arnold, who crashes through the roof. I swear, him and Bubsy have the most horrifying abusive relationship in cartoon history.
Oh my, you made my rash come back!
TMI, Virgil, TMI. Anyways, the twins steal the helmet because Bubsy's incompetent, and T-Bird and the Shrew come on scene. Upon seeing the twins, Boswell decides they should eat the little bastards, and it's official, he is now my favorite character in this whole damn show.
My turn, my turn! I win a pony!
That's not a pony. This is a pony. So the twins fight over the helmet, Sid gets a lot of random and nonsensical violence put upon him, and the twins put the Buzzard and the Shrew on a roller coaster ride. Meanwhile, the idiots finally realize the helmet is gone. I mean, what the hell were they doing all this time?
Have I mentioned that I'm cool? Huh? I'm cool.
Bubsy realizes the twins must have the helmet, and they exit the lab to see the twins have made the whole tri-state area.
Entire tri-state area.
Into an amusement park.
Calm down, Arnold. What could possibly go wrong? Oh, let's do it, Arnold. Let's take the bull by the horns. Let's beat the odds. To the wind! It's time to be heroes for crying out loud!
Aw, the stock footage is over. Now I have to watch Bubsy. Aw.
I mean, what could possibly go wrong?
Watching this show can do that to you.
Terrence? Teresa?
Stop this instant!
Jane, stop this crazy thing!
So the twins stop the roller coaster, sending Bubsy, Arnold, Boswell, and Sid all across the
entire tri-state area.
Yeah. Anyways, Bubsy finds that the twins have made themselves giant, and they accidentally step on him.
It's over!
Nah, the show still goes on, unfortunately. And Bubsy and Arnold aren't too fond of being stepped on.
You should all be put in jail!
Or hung.
Yeah, like that!
Bubsy scolds the twins while Boswell explains his plan of dropping Sid onto the unexpected Bobcat.
Ooh, ooh, bad plan. Not good. Bad plan.
It's a very good plan. You'll catch them totally by surprise and snatch the helmet. Good luck.
Good luck.
Well, Sid grabs the helmet, but Bubsy stops him.
Well, Sidney, I see you finally have the helmet.
How do you know his name, Bubsy? Bubsy trades Sid an exploding corn dog for the helmet and...
Well, I did it. I saved the entire planet. And now, what could possibly go wrong?
Bubsy But unfortunately for Bubsy, the explosion sends Boswell and Sid into him, allowing them to get the helmet and kidnap the twins.
What could possibly go wrong? What could possibly go wrong?
Breach it, brother!
What went wrong?
I would say this entire pilot.
How could this happen to me? I made my mistakes, got nowhere to run.
Well, Bubsy has a whiny emo moment about how he's failed in more ways than I can count. But after electrocuting Arnold, he gets his diabolical glee back and decides to locate the bad guy's hideout by looking them up in the phone book and calling the villains directly? What? That doesn't make sense! If he could look up the villains in the phone book, he wouldn't need to call them because the address would also be in the goddamn phone book! This makes no goddamn sense! What the fuck, guys?
And worst of all, it's not funny either.
Thank you very much. Your brain is indeed very, very small.
God, I hope he's talking about the writers of this show. Anyways, Allie complains that the helmet is giving her helmet hair, as Boswell informs Allie that Sid gave Bubsy their address, and Allie comes up with the most ingenious plan her villainous brain can come up with.
When the Bobcat shows up, we simply refuse to answer the door.
And Bubsy walks in.
If not answering the door was your big plan, maybe you should have, I don't know, tried locking the door. That may have helped. Just a tad.
I don't think so. So, you think you're cute, huh?
I am both attractive and intelligent.
Okay, I hate to admit it, but that was kind of funny and a bit clever.
The characters get in a fight over the helmet. Sid gets a hold of it and wishes for...
Corn dog! No. Corn dog with a B! Oh, no, wait. Corn dog with chickens of I.
Anyways, in predictable cartoon fashion, the helmet gets passed around like a Las Vegas hooker, with each person having their different wish granted.
I, Oblivion, take Buster to be my lawfully wedded...
At Bubsy!
That's still not funny.
Now you're all in hot water.
You know, if they would have ended the cartoon right here, I might have been able to forgive it for, well, about everything. Yeah.
Well, we're back to playing hot potato with a helmet, another truck gag, if you can call it that. Allie gets her own TV show, and Oblivia hits her with the chalkboard again.
Glorious! You ruined your one good gag. Congratulations, Bubsy.
Do something, Bitsy!
Come here, would you? That would be Bubsy!
And for the last time, that's still not funny!
Well, Bubsy has a helmet now. It starts fizzling. Virtual reality gives us some techno-babble about the fact that it's overloading via plot convenience and the helmet is going to explode. So Bubsy decides he will use the helmet to think of the most mind-numbing, amazing way to save the world, which is having the villains all tied up. Yeah, that's whatever.
What a rush! I think I saw Elvis!
Hey Bubsy, I warned you about drinking Four Loko.
Well, with the villain subdued and Oblivia finally getting his name right, Bubsy gives us another stock footage laden speech, and Bubsy tells us,
what could possibly go wrong?
At least there was a reasonable amount of time before he said it this time. Anyways, he says that line and gets himself and Arnold electrocuted, because that's just how you want to end a show.
So that was Bubsy. How was it? Well, let's do the That Funky Guy overview and see.
The goods? Well, it has an all-star voice acting cast, even if they're all wasted on this drivel. And Boswell Buzzard is by far the best character in the whole show. I'm not sure if it's because he's trying to eat the twins, or the fact that he sounds like Thurston Howell from Gilligan's Island. No, definitely the fact he's trying to eat the twins. The bads? Oh god, where do I even start? Well, I've often said that the Bubsy video games are kind of like what you'd get if someone tried to make a Mario or Sonic-styled game when they've never played one before. Similarly, this cartoon is kind of like what you'd get if someone had tried to make a cartoon like Animaniacs or Freakazoid, but never actually watched either of them before. It wastes all of the talented voice actors in this show. The writing tries too hard to be funny by a running gag, stock footage, and random humor that just doesn't exceed on any level. The characters minus Boswell are horribly annoying, unlikable, and incredibly grating. I mean, you have to try hard to make characters this unlikable. Not to mention also having some of the worst character designs I've ever seen. Especially those goddamn twins!
Bubsy is a terrible cartoon that, like Battletoads, didn't make it past the pilot. And for good reason, too. I mean, this show is just bad. Really, really fucking bad. I'd rather see a Battletoads cartoon series than a Bubsy TV series. And that really says something, to be honest. I mean, this is almost Freddy Cat levels of intolerable. The only reason I would say Freddy Cat is worse would have to be because Freddy Cat's an entire series, while Bubsy is a single episode. If Bubsy was a frickin' series, it'd probably be worse than Freddy Cat. But hey, what do I know? I'm not the one who makes this shit, and for one other thing, I just have to say-
You should all be put in jail!